Praise the Lord. Welcome, welcome to tonight's edification, exhortation, and comfort from the Holy Spirit of Christ, of God in Christ. And this will be, well, my name is Prophetess Sought After, coming your way from Augusta, Georgia. And this will be coming from Ephesians 5. Just desire to come on through the Spirit of grace in Jesus' name. And Father, we just thank you right now for your exhortation. Whatever you give me, you know, I ask you to help it to be edifying for the people. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we give you glory, honor, and praise for it. In Jesus' name, amen. And so, now we're going to, I just wanted to come on tonight and to speak to someone who may be asking the Lord something. And the Lord has put on my heart to come on and talk. So, we're going to be coming from Ephesians 5:25, and this is dedicated for speaking to marriages. Marriages according to Ephesians 5. If you never knew it was a word that was according, that had marriages in mind, well, tonight will be some enlightenment. You may be going through some marital problems. You may be having some issues or challenges with your position in the marriage, and you may be overstepping your boundaries in your marriage. You may not be fulfilling it as the Word of God or the faith of Jesus Christ says to do it. So tonight, what I'm doing is coming to enlighten, encourage, give you revelation, give you the teaching of what the grace of God through Jesus Christ, through his holy apostle Paul, has given us according to Ephesians 5:25. Okay? And I'm only a mouthpiece for the Lord. As he gives me direction, that's what I say. So tonight we're going to be speaking on as much as he allows, because he may not allow me to say much, because he want you to be able to get it, okay? Not that you don't already have it, but like I said, this word is for those who are seeking God for salvation in their marriage. See, marriages, everybody loves marriage, but everybody don't want to do the work that marriage takes to do. So even as we are married to Christ, if you have a natural marriage, that natural marriage should exemplify or look like the marriage of Christ and the church. So if it doesn't look like that, then we have to continue to pray, continue to die, continue to cry out to God, continue to reach, continue to forgive. We have to continue to look into the word of faith. We have to continue to believe. I've been married 3 times. And those 3 times, I say that not as something that somebody did me wrong, but I probably did them wrong too. Look at me, said probably. I did some wrong too. Because I didn't have the knowledge. I didn't have the revelation. I didn't have the teaching. I didn't have it. And so when God revealed it to me, and I began to teach that, because things happen in our life for a reason, you know, and it's not for us to glorify ourselves, but it's to glorify God. And so he allowed me to get married 3 times. He allowed it. He allowed three men to leave me. He allowed it. He allowed the rejection. He allowed the abandonment. He allowed the verbal abuse. He allowed it. Even though he did not ordain it, it was allowed for his glory so that I may come on and in this last time give this revelation and doctrine to women that are seeking God and men who are asking the Lord, what is my position? You know, what am I to do with this woman and her saying, why did I marry him? He didn't act like this when we were dating. All of these things are necessary in marriage, because if we had known it before, we wouldn't have been in no divorces, because we would have had the truth. So this is why I want to come forward today. By the grace of God and the gift of Jesus Christ, according to his holy word, through his holy apostle Paul, in Ephesians 5 and 25. So let's begin. Amen. And we're just going to turn here in our Bibles. And if you have your Bible, then go get it. We got time. So we're starting at Ephesians, and we're going to start in verse 25. This is talking to husbands. Are you a husband? If you're a boyfriend, you're not a husband. Are you a husband? Have you taken have you pledged and bind yourself to your wife before God? If you have, then you're a husband. If you have not, then you're in error. We're going to learn tonight, okay? Look, let's see what it says in Ephesians 25. Husbands. This word is to husbands, not boyfriends, not live-ins. Husbands. These are men that band the family together. Husbands. Okay? And if the H is silent, which in some countries it is, it's husbands. Husbands. So it's talking to the one that bands us together. Isn't that something? And so look at here. It says, husbands, love your wives. And here it doesn't mean that you have a lot of wives. It just means it's a plural form. He's talking to all husbands. All husbands have the same assignment. What is the assignment? Love. Who do the husbands love? Your wives. Not nobody else's wife. Your wife. If you chose a woman and you was once in love or thought you was crazy in love with her and you wanted her to be with you for the rest of your life, and you married her and you became one with her, you went into her, that's your wife. Before God. Before God. Okay? It says, love your wives. So apparently she needs this from you. That God would give you such an assignment. Oh my God. To love. So who are you that you can do this? I'm glad you asked, because it says, husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church. So here he's not only telling you to do something, he's giving you an example of the love. Wow. He's giving you an example of the love. So he's a good God that he won't just throw you out there. If you chose to get married, that's what you chose to do. You chose a wife. You have her. Now, what am I supposed to do with her? Now that I have her, you are to love her. What is that? What does that look like? A lot of people say, I love you. I love you too. I love you. But look, I said I love these men. They told me they loved me, but they all walked out. They all left me. They abandoned me with children. They abandoned me with brokenness. They abandoned me with, you know, a broken heart, confused mind, shattered emotions. Oh my. But they said they loved me though. They didn't understand. They didn't know the love. So here God is telling us through his holy word, through the holy apostle, that husbands are to love their wives. This is something that belongs to you. It should belong to you. Now, if it's somebody else's wife, that's not your wife. That's somebody else's wife. And if that woman's husband is still living, that's not your wife. I done been in it. I was in adultery. This was somebody else's husband. He wasn't mine. But God never said about the woman in the Bible, he never referred to her as the husband as her husband. He would say to the husband, this lady's wife, this man's wife. So he would refer, he would refer to the woman under the man. He never said, like if I said Maxine, George, Maxine's husband. No, it don't never do that. It'll say Maxine, George's wife, or Alan's wife, or, you know, whoever else's wife. It will let you know whose wife I was, because a wife is never a head. She's always a body. So that's why he referred to it like that, because even when David married Abigail, even though God struck him with a heart attack because of his demeanor to King David, it'll say Abigail, that Nabal's wife. Yeah, it would never say that Abigail, Nabal's husband. It would never say Nabal's husband. That's what I'm trying to put, is I'm trying to say. And so here we see that he gives the husbands a pattern, a mirror. How does the love look? It looks like Christ. Who is he loving? He's loving the church. That's how husbands are to love their wives. So here we have an assignment. We have a pattern. And now what he says is, you have an activity or an assignment of the husband is to love. That's your activity. That's your assignment. You got to love that. You got to do it. You made to do that. That's what you were created to do. And it said, and we're going to go to why is that their assignment? Because they are the image and glory of God. So if you're the image of God in the natural, and then you're the glory, image and glory. So that means you're made in the spirit first, and then you're the glory of God. That's awesome. Did you know you was the glory of God? And then we know that God is love. So you're made in the image of God. God is love. And you're made the glory. You're the image and the glory. So you're the image and the glory. So when your wife, or when a woman looks at a man, she's looking at the image and glory of God. Oh my, now y'all. Oh my. He said, let us make man in our image after our likeness. That means you're in the spirit of love, because you're in the image, which is spirit, and the likeness of them, likeness of God, is love. God is love. Isn't that beautiful? That's why that's your assignment, is to love. Not this crooked love in this world. Not loving somebody and going to lay with somebody else. Not loving somebody and lying. Loving somebody and cheating. Loving somebody and abusing them. Loving somebody and cursing them out. That's not the way you treat. That's not the way Christ treated the church. He loved the church. He knew who he was supposed to love. He knew his assignment. And it said, husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church. So we're going to just go that far tonight. We're not going to go any further. Meditate on that. Now you know. Are you a husband? Are you not? If you're a husband, this word is talking to you. What is it telling you to do? Love. Not love all these women out here. You chose one already. How are you treating her? You chose her. Just like Christ chose us. He went in the whole world. The whole world. He could have chose anybody. But he chose me. He chose you. He came looking for the church. Oh my. You was looking for a special person. And you found her. That's your church. Hey, glory to God. And now that you found her, see, the Bible says he loved the church. That's who he's, as Christ loved the church. In the role that Christ loved the church is how you're supposed to love your wife. You are her Christ. She looked to you. She trusts you. She believes you. She don't think evil of you. Some of y'all might have women that think evil, but have you caused her to think evil of you? Because you didn't uphold the image that you was made, the glory that you was made in. God. God is love. So we're going to come back. I believe God is going to allow me to come back tomorrow, if the Lord's will that I live. But I just desired to come forth and give you a taste. He said, oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. When you taste, your eyes open. Taste and see. Taste and see that the Lord is good. The Lord is good. And he made you in his image, husband. You're good. No matter if nobody ever told you you was good. You're good because you was made by God. He's a good God. So I'm just encouraging you today, first of all, if you're a husband, God is requiring something of you, and it's that you love. Allow the love to come forth by faith. Let it come forth by faith. It's in there. You are love. You was created in the image and the likeness. So that means you in spirit, you in love. You was created in the image. God is spirit. God is love. That's what you've been seeking. But if you don't have Christ, you can't do it. Christ is our life. You must be born again. If you've been married and if you're married and you wasn't born again, and you may have married 2 and 3 times like me, we have to repent because we did it wrong. But it wasn't your fault because he said he's not holding that against you. But you can't do it again. You have to repent and you have to turn from that wicked way. You have to turn from that evil. You have to turn in the name of the Lord. You have to ask the Lord to come into your life. Well, actually, you need to go into his life, because he's already took our life to the cross. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. So now, if you believe these words and you're a husband and you desire goodness from the Lord and you desire to know who you are in the Lord, first of all, you're good. Second of all, your spirit. Third of all, your love. Good things of the Lord. Fourth of all, if you got married and those marriages fail, God can do it again. He can do it for you. You have to acknowledge him in all your ways. If you've gotten out of those marriages, then don't seek a marriage. If you're in marriage, don't seek to get divorced from a marriage. That's according to the faith. You got to stay right there and let God work it. You got to let God work it for you. He can do it. You got to repent. If you're in adultery, you got to repent. You got to repent. God will tell you what to do. I mean, I was in adultery, and I had to repent because I didn't want the Lord to come and I got somebody else's somebody. I didn't want nobody else's somebody. And the man was already cheating on me and all. So we be knowing the truth. If they not ours, sometimes you got to do the hard thing. I'm not telling you to leave. I'm not telling you to stay. You got to do what God tell you to do. But you got to repent. I know that. And he forgives. Because even the woman that was in adultery, he told her, he that is without sin, let him cast the first stone. So I can't condemn you. But he told her, where are your accusers? She said, I don't have any. He said, neither do I accuse you. Go and sin no more. He told her to go and sin no more. She was caught in the very act of adultery. The very act of adultery. That means she had somebody else's husband. And he told her to go. He didn't accuse her. He said, go and sin no more. That means she couldn't go back to that man again. Because that was sin. So now we got to be ready to make the choice. Are you ready? If you're ready to make the choice, you need to repent. And once you repent, God will lead you. It's up to you. God not accusing you. He's not. But you can't sin anymore. And that means that if you in that marriage and you married, y'all might have had kids and all that, you got to repent. But then you can't sin no more. That means you can't, if that marriage don't work, you can't marry nobody else. Because you already was in sin and he forgave us. He said some of y'all was adulterous. But God washed us. And if he washed us, that means we're new creatures now. If you believe in Christ, he know if you believe in him or not. I just come to let you know that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Do you believe today? If you believe today, I come to let you know that God is not holding that sin against you. But he's using me to come and let you know to be reconciled to God. He's using the Christ in me as though Christ is talking to you right now, saying, be ye reconciled to God. God is not angry with you. Make a choice today to not be angry with yourself, but to repent and to receive the love that God has for us. He said, come. He's calling you. And we're going to talk about this again, but I just wanted to talk to husbands tonight. We'll talk further when he bring me back on. Please like this video, share it, subscribe, so that you can know the truth, and the truth can make you free. Again, my name is Maxine, also known as Sought After, here in Augusta, Georgia. And this is the ministry of Christ. It's not my ministry. it's a ministry of Christ, but I do put a title on it, you know, because I talk to women, so. But for now, I just choose to say it's the ministry of Christ, our Lord. Okay? And until next time, God bless you. Father God, I pray for the people that's watching, and I ask you to let them receive your words in the name of the Lord Jesus. I thank you for who's listening. I thank you for touching their heart. I thank you for your forgiveness of their sin. I thank you for making it right on your cross, on your blood. Hey, let them believe in your name, turn from their wicked ways, and receive you, Father. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I pray. Amen. Thank you. Until next time, God bless you. Go in peace. In the grace of God, be multiplied to you. In Jesus' name, amen.